My mother came from Arecibo, Puerto Rico, when she was about 11 years old, maybe. It was a classic story of looking for a better life. My mother's the youngest, so her mother passed away. Her older sister started to get sick and pass away, and there was this sense of a generation of stories that was all of a sudden disappearing into thin air. So I started interviewing them and writing stories down about what it was like to arrive as a Latina in Philadelphia in the 60s. And the stories were kind of amazing. And it started dawning on me, I hold a key to maybe just a little part of our American story that hasn't made it to the shelves yet. And that for me was the key to thinking about my life as a writer. Not seeing oneself and truly one's community members on stage, it's just a breakdown of conversation. It stops a conversation before it even happens. In some ways, my ideal audience member is someone who has never seen themselves reflected on stage and sees that for the first time in my work. And I also, at the same time, think the other side of the coin is that my ideal audience member is someone who doesn't relate to these characters at all and hasn't had these experiences and yet goes for the ride. It's those points of overlap that really turn me on as a writer. You know, it's not just what happens within the boundaries of one community, but what happens when those boundaries touch others and there's exchange.